Hi, I'm Dr. Chad Cherington over at Ironwood Research and Cancer Centers in Mesa. I'm a medical oncologist and a hematologist, and frequently I see patients with an abnormal blood test who ask me why they're seeing a medical oncologist. Well, being a medical oncologist places me as a specialist in cancer, but also I'm also a hematologist, which is a doctor of any blood disorder. So that can be an anemia, where sometimes we give IV iron infusions, or that could be something as a bleeding problem or a blood clotting problem, among other blood disorders. Well, we do particular training as far as all the different, how the blood is to be balanced out. You know, we have tend to have a good sense of what's normal and what's more, you know, concerning as far as, you know, a blood disorder that may be related to a cancer versus one that's related to something that may be less serious. And, you know, most blood disorders are not related to a cancer, the vast majority. So, you know, the first step is always looking at the blood test. And oftentimes I have to order a few other blood tests to sort things out. But just be reassured that, that most of the time it's, you know, a non-cancer related problem that's causing the abnormality. Common things that I see would be an iron deficiency anemia, or an anemia related to some other nutritional deficiency, or maybe a gut malabsorption disorder. Other things I see are abnormal white blood cells. Oftentimes, you know, the blood cells are either too high or too low. And there's actually a few different dozen potential causes, whether it be nutritional, stress, pain, you know, autoimmune problem, or, you know, cancer tends to be the least likely problem. Most patients that I see with an abnormal blood test are not going to have cancer, you know, the far vast majority of them. And in fact, you know, being a hematologist as well, more than, you know, half my patients do not have cancer and may have some, you know, blood disorder. So the first things we always do is just get a good history and then check some blood work. And a lot of times we can sort out the cause of the blood abnormality from those first two steps.